Almost a third of the Great Barrier Reef's corals have died after back-to-back bleaching events in 2016 and 2017. Now new corals are under stress and struggling to survive in the aftermath.
My area of research interest is understanding how some corals are more resilient to stress than others, and if there's indicators, particularly biomarkers that we can identify that tell us why some corals are able to withstand stresses like pollution, temperature, low pH, which we're seeing increasing.
Dr. Emma Camp hopes early identification of the destructive impacts on coral can help improve reef management.
We still have reef that is worth fighting for and that we should be studying to try to conserve, but there's urgency because we obviously have lost a lot in a very short space of time.
The Great Barrier Reef contributes around $6.5 billion a year to our economy, but its value to our ecosystem is priceless.
The fact that the reef's only 0.1% of the ocean floor but houses over 25% of marine biodiversity shows how rich and valuable this system is.
Seabed environments are also vital for marine biodiversity and ecosystem function and are under threat from large ships. Allison Broad is studying the impact of anchors and large chains being dropped and dragged along the seabed.
Because of the size of these vessels, they're often hundreds of metres long, so they require several hundred metres of chain to be deployed to hold their position.
Her research involves monitoring the damage caused to marine biodiversity using remote technologies.
I often get to investigate areas that I know nobody's ever seen before, and then being able to showcase them to the public is really exciting because then it makes them curious about marine environments that we have locally.
Both scientists are receiving the Max Day Award for their research.
It's really exciting and it will contribute towards the success of the project.
Such a privilege to be associated with such a prestigious award and organisation.